Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. We will continue from where we arrived today, yesterday. But before that, the student said, Ya Sultan, O Ya Shaykh, Allah, Fazil, the Rastani, Mother. The student said, Ya Muhammad Nazim, Al-Haqqani, Walad. We mentioned about Mufti Shafi'iyya yesterday, about Imam Ahmad Zayd. Ahmad Zayn al-Dahlan, about the prayers on Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So we'll continue today, but before I continue, I think most of you, because every day people changes here, so many might not have heard the beginning of this series. They can go to Sufi Life and they can watch it on Sufi Life, because it's one after each other, every day it's been uploaded, and you can see how we are progressing, and especially about the issue of the hadith of Tirmidhi that I mentioned to you, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has stroke on the back of Sayyidina Adam and all his zurriya came out, and we explained that hadith in detail, and Sayyidina Adam, like one of his zurriya, that he saw a light coming from his eyes, he said, Ya Rabbi, who is that? He said, this is one of your children, grandchildren, coming at the end of the Ummah, many nations later. He said, give him, how old you made his life? He said, 60 years. He said, give him 40 years from my life. And Allah gave. Allah said, Azrael came to take the soul of Sayyidina Adam. He said, still I have 40 years. He said, how you have 40 years? You forgot that you gave your son Dawood that 40 years, and Allah accepted. That is the hadith of Tirmidhi, and it is hadith Hasan Sahih. When we say Hasan Sahih, means no question about it. It's not da'if to say there is question. It's Hasan Sahih. Those who know the principle of hadith, they will understand that. If someone say how many categories of hadith there are, how many of them under different categories, I will say there is 52 different categories of hadith. And this is only scholar can understand these things, not normal people. Now I'll explain that when I debated one of the rabita that they have sent to me from Hijaz to America, his name is Muhammad Adli, it's also on the internet, about the existence of tasawwuf, where is mentioned tasawwuf in Quran and in hadith. It was a debate, open debate, on the internet, 1991. Before anyone knew about the internet, 1991, we have that debate on the internet in America. He was from New York, I was from California, and I gave him the evidences and the explanation. So in any case, there are cases that people gave from their life to their shiuch, or the shiuch gave to their who? Say, speak, what's the good?
Murid.
Why are you afraid? If in Egypt you are sitting in a majlis of advice, Tariqatuna as-suhba wal-khayru fi al-jam'iyya, and you keep quiet, they close the majlis and they go to the sheikh. If you say yes, you say yes. You know, no. Don't be like statue. We are like statue. What you say? Yes.
Yes.
Is it correct?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
When you say yes, sir, means confirmed.
Yes.
So, I asked that Mawlana, may Allah give him long life, to give us more evidences. He reminded me about the story of Shaykh Zia and Shaykh Sharafuddin.
You heard that story before?
It's Mawlana's story. And it is in the Naqshbandi book. Once, Shaykh Sharafuddin came to Istanbul. One time, Shaykh Sharafuddin coming to visit Istanbul, he stayed in a hotel called Masarrat. You know, Masarrat is a hotel, I don't know if it still exists till today. Masarrat means in Arabic happiness, the happy hotel. He stayed in that hotel and he was asked by a person that he was a scholar called Sheikh Zia. Zia Allah, or Zia al-Haq, or Zia al-Din. But not mentioned in his family, they say Sheikh Zia. And he looked at Sheikh Sharafuddin. He's a sheikh. Maybe he's a wali. Maybe he's one from the Abdal. You know Abdal? Huh?
Yes. Yes, sir.
You know Abdal?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Substitute. Abdal al-Sham. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if you are in a place that you get scared, in desert or forest, call upon Abdal al-Sham, those hidden 40 wali that no one knows them except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and awliya Allah, of course. Call on them, they come and support you. You think Abdal al-Sham are sitting, they're not doing anything now? They are everywhere. One time GrandShaykh, may Allah bless his soul, Shaykh Abdullah Dagestani, was going out from his house in the mountain. Everyone knows his house or no one knows his house?
Yes,
yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Some of them don't know his house. Say, no, sir.
No, no, sir.
It's up on the mountain. He was going in a carriage with one sheikh. I have to remember his name. Toward Sheikh Muhyiddin ibn Arabi's maqam, his mosque. You know his mosque. They were in a carriage. He was very famous, Abdul Wahhab al-Sarahi, his name. He was a very famous scholar. And he loves Mawlana Sheikh Abdullah a lot. They were in this on the carriage and the horse moving. And suddenly one person appeared, hold the horse. And he looked at Abdul Wahhab al-Salahi and he spoke and asked him, is he your sheikh or you are his sheikh? Is he, yani grand sheikh, your sheikh or you are his sheikh? Because they were very near the age. What he answered? Normal person, what he would answer? Is he your sheikh or you are you his sheikh? What do you say? He said, because no one said he is, you are afraid to say what. He said,
He is not my sheikh and I'm not his sheikh. Immediately that person disappeared. And Abdul Wahab al-Sarahi looked at Mawlana Sheikh, Grand Sheikh, and said, oh, my Sheikh, how? Just now he was there. And now he's disappeared. He asked, who is there? Are you my Sheikh or am I your Sheikh? I said, you are not your Sheikh. I said, and I am not your Sheikh. And you heard that. He said, yes. But this word had a bad smell, what you said. Awliya Allah, they cannot carry the bad smell. Awliya Allah, what? What?
Cannot
carry the bad smell that comes from the mouth of the murid. How many bad smells come from our mouth to the Sheikh? Look, he's asking him, is you your sheikh or you are his sheikh? He said, he's not my sheikh and I am not his sheikh. He is showing humbleness. I'm not his sheikh, but I am a sheikh. And he's not my sheikh. And I am not his sheikh. That was a bad smell. What do you think if you backbite and go tell the sheikh something which is not correct? What will happen? Bad smell comes from your mouth, like cigar or cigarette, or worse, cigar and cigarette still it's okay. Might be something that you go to daily when you want to make wudu. Might be like that smell. Bad smell. Grand Sheikh, may Allah bless his soul, he said one time they were praying Sahaba with Prophet Taraweeh. And Jibreel coming with revelation. And he stopped. Was not descending anymore. Stopped. And Sayyidina Muhammad said, Ya Jibreel, why are you not coming with the revelation? He said, I cannot stand the bad smell that coming from the mouth of Sahaba. And the angels cannot stand it. He said, what kind of bad smell? Oh, they are my Sahaba. They are, as Prophet said, my Sahabati kal-Nujum. You know that hadith? Kal-Nujum. بِأَيِّهِمْ اُقْتَدَيْتُمْ اِهْتَدَيْتُمْ. You follow any one of them, you will be guided. He said, no, this is, they have bad smell because they ate onion and garlic tonight at iftar. Angels cannot stand the bad smell of onion and garlic, although onion and garlic cure 70 difficult sicknesses in a human being. But angels cannot stand the smell. What about those people who are on the ears of others, backbiting, creating fitna, saying things out of context, saying things out of normal, and those who are believing it, they are making, those who believe it, they are not the sinner, the one who was saying the false rumor is the sinner. The one who believes, he believes. What? Al-Mu'min, he believes. He believes, he thinks the other one is a mu'min, he believes. علامات المنافق ثلاث إذا حدث كذب. Signs of a munafiq corrupted three. If he speaks, he lies. One of them. إذا حدث كذب. If he speaks, he lies. وإذا وفى وعدا أخلف. If he is promised, he break his promise. وَإِذَا تَمَنَ خَانَ وَإِذَا تَمَنَ خَانَ. If you trust him on something, he betrays you. إِذَا حَدَّثَ كَذَبَ. If he speaks, he lies.
how many not here. MashaAllah, here are very good. On the second section, they speak, they lie. That's why they don't put the other camera. Because they know that they are, they might hit on them. So they keep away. No problem. We don't care. What we care is love to our Shaykh. That's it. Correct? So إذا حدث كذب. If he speaks, he lies. So what Allah said? تبينوا يا أيها الذين آمنوا إن جاءكم فاسق بنبأ فتبينوا. Oh believers, if someone corrupted came to you with something, check it. وإذا تمنى خان. You trust him on something secret or something that say to him something, he goes and he betrays you. He goes to the police and say, oh, they are terrorist organizations. Huh? Oh, to the police, they want to do this, they want to do that. You have proof? You have proof, bring the proof. Correct? Am I lying?
No.
Put his camera on him.
Camera's on.
Am I lying?
No.
It's a good one. That's why they don't like him. But well, they are afraid from it. Because he's here. I'm not here, so they are not afraid. They don't care. Never. They made them to get one Pakistani who is, he didn't do anything. First time coming here to be stopped 24 hours and beat it up. They beat him up. And next day someone supported them. Allahu Akbar. Is a haddatha kadab. He speaks. Lies. Tumira khan. Trust him, he betray you. Wa'ida?
Wa'ada
akhla. If he promise, oh, I am good, I promise, I didn't do that, I love you. And then this and that and that. Akhlaf. He will not think, he will, in front of your face, lahu wajhan. He has two faces. Not he, whatever, who is, he, she, them, So we cannot lie. So what Sayyidina Shaykh, what Sayyidina GrandShaykh Abdullah Daghestani said to that Abdul Wahhab al-Sarahi? And that story is GrandShaykh has mentioned it. No one can deny it. We are not Buddhist. They say we are Buddhist. 50 years with Mawlana Shaykh, we are Buddhist.
Allah.
And points, we mentioned the hadith of coins. Yeah. We mentioned the hands, holding hands. So, he said, you gave bad smell from your mouth. He said, well, I didn't do anything. He asked me, who is the Shaykh? I said, he is not my Shaykh, and I'm not his Shaykh. It's good, it's humbleness. I'm not his Shaykh. I was able to say, I'm his Shaykh. He said, no, didn't show humbleness. What you would have lost if you said to him, he is my Shaykh? You lose anything? That has nice smell, but the way you said it has bad smell. So awliya Allah, they smell their followers. Don't think if someone is think himself, herself, themselves near to the Shaykh, they are not smelling. No, they are smelling bad smell.
Bad smell comes from their words that they speak, if they lie. The Shaykh knows, but keep quiet. That doesn't say, because Allah, His name is what? As-Sattar. Allah, His name? As-Sattar, the veiler. He veiled the mistake of His servants. Awliya Allah, they inherit from that secret. What are you thinking about Sultan al-Awliya? He's going to say something? He will dress you, he will say you are the best wali on earth, and everyone must follow you, everyone must listen to you, everyone must come to you, you are wazir of Mahdi, you are even Mahdi, he will say to you. To make you happy. This tariqah is idkhal al-surur ila qalb al-abd min al-iman. You have to know sharia. To give evidence. To make people happy is from iman. So make them happy. Why are you losing? Nothing. So if you said that to Abdul Wahhab al-Salahi, if you said, he is my sheikh, he would have been here. He is here, I'm seeing him. But you are not seeing him. I didn't say something that gives bad smell for him to run. He ran from your bad smell, he veiled. But from my smell, he's there, I'm seeing him. Say salamu alaykum. So he came to teach you adab. How much adab we need? That's why we were speaking about the greatness of Prophet and Salawat on Prophet. I brought this in order to say that Rahmatullah is huge. That Allah will forgive everyone by Salah ala Nabi, because it is the only thing that makes you, that Prophet will intercede for you. Before I go to Shaykh Sharafuddin back, I will say that it is said that some of Awliya Allah, they said, قَالَ بَعْضُ الْعَارِفِينَ بِاللَّهِ مَنْ فَاتَهُ كَثْرَةُ الصَّلَاةِ وَالصِّيَامِ فَلْيُكْسِرْ مِنَ الصَّلَاةِ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. Anyone understood that? مَنْ فَاتَهُ كَثْرَةُ الصِّيَامِ وَالصَّلَاةِ فَلْيُصَلِّ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. What's that mean? Whoever missed many fastings and prayings, many fastings and many prayers, he missed them. Many people, they miss Ramadan. And they miss prayers. What he has to do? He has to make them up for sure, but he must increase and make salawat on Prophet always. Because prayers is obedience to Allah. When you pray, you show obedience. When you fast, you show what? Obedience. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So he said, because Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, فَإِنَّ مَنْ صَلَّ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ مَرَّةً صَلَّى اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَلَيْهِ عَشْرٌ. Whoever make one salawat on Prophet, Allah will make 10 salawat on him. That's good, huh? You make one salawat on Prophet, let's say, اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد. Now we get 10 salawat from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Is our salawat like Allah's salawat? Is it?
No, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir.
فَلَوْ فَعْلَ الْإِنسَانُ جَمِيعَ الطَّاعَاتِ
Look, here the important thing. If a human being, anyone, from the day he was born until the day he was he died, he will do all kind of obligations that Allah obliged him to do. All of them. كل الطاعات وصلى على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم مرة واحدة لرجحت تلك الصلاة الواحدة على كل أعماله. If he prays on Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم one time, it will be more heavier than all his ta'at, all his prayers and fasting and hajj and all what kind of obligation he did, it will be heavier in this case. Why? You want to know why? When you mention the sabab, yaktub al-ajab. When you mention the cause, then you will not be stunned or astonished and thinking why. Why? Because when you make one prayer, Allah makes for you 10 prayers. So who is heavier, Allah's prayers or your ta'ah or your obedience? Allah's prayers. So if you have done all prayers from day of beginning of dunya till the day of resurrection, always you are up and down in sajda, qiyam, ruku', sujood, and make one salawat, Allah will make 10. Allah's 10 salawat more heavier in the scale than your salawat, than your prayers. That's why they said, awliyaullah, awliyaullah, they understand this. They said, if you missed from Ramadan, or you missed from prayers, make them up. Because even if you make them up, it's not equal to the, it is not going to be equal to the time when you have to do the, in Ramadan, or you do on time the prayers. But the prayers that Allah has sent you, because you prayed on Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, will be more heavier in your scale. لأنك تصلي على حسب وسعك. Because you pray and fast and make ta'at to Allah according to your capacity. But when Allah makes on you 10 salawat, He will make according to His capacity. Cannot say capacity to Allah. Greatness. And when we say greatness, Allahu Akbar, no limit. Wherever you say Akbar is Akbar, he is above that. He's more Akbar, more Akbar, more Akbar. So according to his greatness, he is sending you the 10 salawat. So say Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali Sayyidina Muhammad. What you get now? 10 salawat from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala according to his greatness. أَنْ يَرْحَمُكَ عَلَى حَسَبِ رُبُوبِيَّتِهِ. He will mercy you according to his lordship, to his greatness. So that Abdul Wahhab al-Salahi, we go back. If he says that is my Shaykh, angels will be happy, approach him and say, Ya Rabbi, this person showed humbleness to one of your awliya. Raise him. Allah will raise him. But you didn't do that. You didn't accept it. So this, we must have a good smell. You must not have a bad smell. That is from today. We say we forgive each other. This internet is on. And people are watching from all over the world. We say let us forget each other. Let us forget forgive each other. Let us forgive all the humanity. Let us be good in our country, especially in Western countries. To abide by the law, obey Allah, obey Prophet, obey the authority. We obey the authority. We obey Allah, we obey Prophet. We love everyone. Show love to non-Muslim. Tell them that Islam is love. Islam is perfect. Iman is perfect. Ihsan is perfect. You are our brothers in humanity. May Allah guide us and guide you. What's the problem? Show humbleness. And we say, may Allah forgive everyone here. And they forgive us, we forgive them. What's the big issue? But don't be munafiq. إِذَا حَدَّثَ كَذَبْ. If he speaks, he lies. He might say to you, yeah, you are my friend, you are my friend. I forgive you, you forgive me. And then we see police coming. Oh, Allahu Akbar, what happened? Police coming, what happened? Ah, we are here watching, be careful. Watch. We are all around the world, all the world knows us. From presidents to prime ministers to ministers. To people. We don't do anything wrong. Mawlana taught us to love everyone and to be humble with everyone. So that Ziya, Shaykh, ask Shaykh Sharafuddin, look what kind of question. Go back to the story. Stayed in Hotel Masarrat, in that hotel in Turkey, I don't know if it's still existing or not. He was asked by a person named Sheikh Ziya, how you are going to die? What question? How you are going to die? I want to know how you are going to die. Might be he wants to get a secret from Sheikh Sharafuddin that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy is big. He will forgive you and forgive me and forgive everyone. Might be. He said, and Sheikh Sharafuddin said, is that an important question to you, how I am going to die? Is it something important that you are asking me how I am going to die? He said, no, my Sheikh, but it came to my heart to ask that question. That's why whatever comes to your heart, don't bring it on your tongue. It's not appropriate. Adab of tariqah, discipline of tariqah. Not everything comes to the heart you say on your mouth. Awliya Allah, they call this craziness. Anything comes to your heart, you dump it out. You think something wrong because... For what? Balance it. Check it. Is it going to make a problem? Is it going to make a bad situation? Is it going to be riba? Is it going to be namima? Is it going to be good question? If you want to ask the Sheikh, my Sheikh, how I'm going to make salawat on Prophet, that even not accepted. Until the Sheikh, he tells you how. He told you in the Awrat book how, finish. You don't ask. In tariqah there is no question, because Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not ask in Holy Quran not even one question. You read the whole Holy Quran, there is no one question from Prophet to Allah, there is only question from Sayyidina Musa to Allah. He said, I will die when we have an invasion from Armenia. Then he answered, when Armenia at that time was entering Turkey, when Armenia entered, it was Safar Republic. When Armenia would enter Turkey, that time I would die. He's giving ahead to show that we know, but
You don't talk, but you ask, I've answered. And there will be a great deal of oppression at that time. Too much oppression. And there was too much oppression. I heard from GrandShaykh that many scholars were being executed at that time. And Shaykh Ziya, what he said, "Oh God, oh Allah," when he heard that, look, he was sincere. He was sincere. He said, "Oh Allah, take away that difficulty from us, the invasion of the Armenian, and spare our beloved Shaykh. Take away this problem, the invasion of the Armenian away from us, and spare the life of my Shaykh. Spare it." The next day, and this is not in front of Sheikh Sharafuddin, he asked Sheikh Sharafuddin, he said, "I will die when the Armenian will enter Istanbul, Turkey." So he went home and he said, "Oh Allah, spare my Shaykh life. Don't take it and spare us our this difficulty." The next day, Sheikh Sharafuddin said to him, "Oh Sheikh Ziya, what you have been doing all night praying? You were praying all night? Where you were praying all night? What you were doing last night? Your prayer, Ya Sheikh Ziya, your prayer has been accepted." How did you? Ahead of time. He said, "Your prayer has been accepted. Many people, their prayers are accepted. And yesterday, I heard from someone very close to His Highness said that he asked 1 week before he died by his personal assistant that may Allah spare my Sheikh's life, I give my life." You heard that? I heard that. When love overtake a person, it's finished. There is no boundaries. Allah accept. "Oh Sheikh Ziya, what you have been doing all night praying, your prayer has been accepted. That difficulty has been taken from me, but you will suffer instead of me and you will die as a shaheed." Sheikh Sharafuddin said to Sheikh Ziya, "Your prayer is accepted. That problem, that suffering is going to be taken away from me and you are going to die as a martyr, shaheed." After that incident in the hotel of Masarra, it took 8 years. 8 years. The Armenians and Greeks entered Rashadiya. They entered what is called today Gunekoy. Rashadiya, where is Sheikh Sharafuddin Zawiya. His Zawiya still today, people go and visit. His holy shrine is on the top of the mountain with Sheikh Abu Muhammad al-Madani there also of the golden chain. Entered Rashadiya. Ziya Effendi was shot dead. As soon as they entered, they shot him dead. He died as martyr because he spared his life to Sheikh Sharafuddin. Correct?
Yes, sir.
And the prediction of Sheikh Sharafuddin came to pass. And what he said came true. So can anyone spare his life, give it to someone else? Yes?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Can Shaykh spare his life to his murid? Yes,
yes,
sir.
Yes, yes, sir.
Can murid spare his life to the Shaykh?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Can Shaykh and murid, anyone, can spare their life to someone who loves?
Yes, yes, sir.
That's why Sahaba used to say, Fidaka Abi wa Ummi and Nafsi wa Nafsi, Ya Rasulullah. May Allah spare, take our life and give to you, Ya Muhammad. في جواهر المعاني, in the book, the jewels of meanings, and it is by Imam Shahrani, he said, what is Akbar Zikrullah? What is the greatest Zikrullah? Benefit. The greatest one that you get benefit. وأكبر ذكر الله فائدة وأعظمه جدوى وعائدة. And the best that gets your reward هي الصلاة على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, is to praise Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. You want to die, everyone pray for that. You want to die peacefully, make salawat on Prophet. You want to die rewarded paradises and Hur al-Ain, as we explained in Shaykh Qasim. He was looking at Hur al-Ain one eye, and then he turned his face towards his Shaykh. He said, I want my Shaykh to be the last breath I would give out to see him, not Hur al-Ain, I'm not interested. You want to be the last of what you see is your Shaykh, make salawat on Prophet. فإنها متكفرة بجميع مطالب الدنيا والآخرة. Salawat on Prophet is the one that can sponsor you, متكفرة. When you sponsor someone, it sponsors you. Whatever you ask from dunya and akhirah, it will be supporting you for that in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that salawat. Daf'an wa jalban. If you have a problem, to throw away the problem, make salawat. If you need something to come to you, jalban, make salawat. وَإِنَّ مَنْ أَكْثَرَ اسْتِعْمَالَهَا كَانَ مِنْ أَكْبَرِ أَصْفِيَاءِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى. And who will use it mostly, he will be one of awliyaullah that Allah has chosen them. It is page 144, volume 1 of Bab Ash'ara. We stop here. We continue next day. Next time, Imam Khalid al-Baghdadi, Sayyidina Khalid al-Baghdadi, how he spared his life to others. Are you here? Okay. Wa min Allahi tawfiq wa hurmat al-Fatiha. I'm looking there, I'm worried. They will shout at me. Ya Allah, assalamu alaikum. See you next time, inshallah.